Okay, here we go. Time to meet the public. Hey, guys, can I read you some of my new novel?
Of course.
Oh, I love to give notes.
I'm not doing anything.
Awesome. Okay. Eons ago.
What the f***?
This sucks.
It makes me want to kill myself.
You made me hate reading more than I already do.
Wait, what? Is it really that bad?
Let's kick him in the nuts.
I deserve this.
Go ahead. We want to hear it.
I don't know. You know what? It's not ready yet. I got a paper cut on my dong.
Hey, Alex, how's the writing going?
Ugh, terrible.
I bet a lot of successful authors have felt this way. You should ask one for advice. Maybe email Dr. Seuss.
Oh, buddy, he's 100% dead.
No! Why didn't anybody tell me?
Oh, I went to Skylight Books to take a selfie in the poetry section, and they're doing a signing by that guy who writes that horny space stuff you love.
Jack Kleghorn? Author of Lust of the Starwizards 1 through 4, the unfinished pentology?
Yeah, that sounds the right amount of gross.
He's my favorite writer.
If he's your Seuss, go talk to him before it's too late.
I say, looks like we've got ourselves a bit of a Cleghead.
Oh, you have no idea, Mr. Kleghorn.
Please, call me Sir Jack.
Thank you so much, Mr. Sir Jack. I'm actually a bit of a writer, too.
Really?
I mostly write erotic sci-fi epics about cyborg Vikings fighting evil space gods.
Do you know?
I actually just finished a novel, but...
Finish the novel, you say?
Yeah, but I'm too scared to let anyone read it. Did you ever feel like this?
You mean the existential fear that someone may read your work and discover you to be a fraud?
Yes!
No.
Oh.
But it sounds like all you need is a dram of confidence. Why don't you send me your novel, and then stop by my chateau to chat about it?
You want to read?
Alex, my boy, welcome to my humble 18th century mansion I had flown in piece by piece from Windsor. I'm quite wealthy, you see, from writing. Can I get you anything? A spot of tea? Antique sword? Rembrandt?
Wow, are those real?
Oh, yes. I like to keep a couple of mummies around to lift my spirits. Who's still alive now? Amenhotep!
And what is this?
Ooh, that ancient meteor. It's actually quite helpful with my process. Now let's stop pushing about and get into it. I read your novel and I loved it like a badger loves brambleberries.
You, Jack Kleghorn? Sir Jack Kleghorn loved my novel?
When Psybjorn seduces Lord Universo to discover his weakness, I practically... what's the American phrase? Busted a nut.
Ah! This is... Oh, I just...
Don't get too excited, old sport. You have work to do if you want to be the next Sir Jack Kleghorn.
Yes! Yes! I'll do whatever I have to do!
Then get to writing!
Wait, right now?
Type, boy, type! Do you think James Patterson has confidence issues? He finished a book since I started this sentence!
It seems like like Jack is working you to the bone.
Sir Jack is working me to the bone, and I'm fine. My favorite author thinks I've got potential, and I finally feel confident.
Why does he make you do a ton of exercise?
Strong body, strong mind, no doy. You wouldn't get it.
We think you should at least get some sleep.
Jack says sleep is for wankers, and wanking is for losers, so I don't do either anymore.
Alex, you're being insane.
Oh, I see. You're all jealous. I'm going back to Sir Jack's, and if you don't like it, you can kiss my novel writing ass. You close the door, Josh. Sir Jack!
His name is Alex Dorpenberger. He's brilliant! A once-in-a-generation talent!
Yes!
You've got to meet him right away.
I'm sorry. I couldn't help overhearing. Was that...
My agent, dear boy. I was just calling to let him know that I'm the next you.
That is incredible. Wait, don't you mean I'm the next you?
Absolutely not. Wakey, wakey, eggs and bakey. I hope I didn't bash your bally brains in.
Oh, what the hell's going on?
We're going to do a little Freaky Friday.
What?
We're swapping bodies, dear boy.
Oh, okay, got it. You're crazy.
Crazy about eternal life. How would you like to hear a yarn?
Do I have a choice?
Once upon a time, 44,000 years ago, give or take, I was but a humble caveman. 'Twas the early days of art, but I saw how rewarding it could be. I saw an opportunity to cash in. I was history's first plagiarist, but that didn't bust anyone's nuts.
But then...
miracle. This space meteor had caused us to
switch bodies.
I'd escaped death, and as a bonus, I was able to rip off the other guy without consequence. My life, as the modern teens say, slammed. And with the meteor in my possession, it never had to end. Whenever my body grew old, I'd find an undiscovered young artist, let them churn out fresh content, take over their body, and murder the poor twit.
So, wait a minute. You're just some kind of crappy thief?
I'm an exceptional thief, Mr. Dorpenberger. Time for you to shut what is soon to be my mouth.
Oh, no! I'm old as shit!
Well, everything seems to be tickety-boo. Let's get to killing you, shall we? Bollocks! I always forget to untie myself before swapping.
Guys, you have to help me. I'm actually Alex. Sir Jack used a magic meteor to swap bodies with me.
Okay, at first I thought you were just really good at impressions, and I was like, hello, SNL. But the meteor thing makes more sense.
Look, you guys were right when you said Sir Jack was mistreating me, but you've gotta help me!
Alex?
Not for long. The hello for the manuscripts and meteor, and I shall decapitate you.
Oh, you're way hotter with that voice.
Hey!
My precious!
Whoa, everyone's freaking huge!
Hell yeah, I'm old enough to cut!
I am literally inside my ex. My therapist is gonna love this.
Wait, so who's in Bridgette?
That's Sir Bridgette.
Josh, you need to do some curls!
I did not think that through.
No, you really didn't. Anywho, enjoy hell!
Stop! Let her Ergo, or I'll torch the manuscripts.
What sort of imbecile would destroy his life's work?
An imbecile who loves his friends.
No! My livelihood!
Catch!
Oh, that's no good.
Can someone please cover my eyes?
Well, that took a ton of math, but I think everyone is who they're supposed to be at this point.
I'm sorry your idol turned out to be an ancient body-stealing fraud.
Could happen to anyone. Guess I should cancel my meeting with Jack's agent, though.
You must have something you can show him.
Nope. This was everything. Unless... And then... Right at the last second, they switch bodies again, and Jack dies. The end.
Yeah, it's gonna be a pass.
That's fair.